So guys, this beautiful car is an Audi TT, and let's review it. Let's start with the design of the Audi TT. So, coming to the front, you can notice it like it is an Audi because of this huge grille and the four rings of the Audi badge. Then you have got your front bumper, which is real and it fits air into the radiators. And they've got a cool design in them, a rectangle design. Then, coming over here, you've got fake vents. See, fake vents here also. Then you have your fog lights over here and your main lights over here, and these are LEDs. And then you're coming to the bonnet, you've got a crease starting from here all the way to the end of here, and it is the same on the opposite side. Then you've got wide wheel arches. See, they're wide over here. And you've got 18-inch rims, which look stunning and are nice and beautiful. Then, coming to the sides, you have your door mirrors. You have your Audi badge over here, the four rings. You have got your blinkers over here. So you've got body color over here on the top and black on the bottom. And when you look at this car, you think it's a black car. But it's not, it's a really dark blue, and I call this dark eye black. So then you have got a crease starting from here all the way to the back over here, on the ends over here. See, it's over there. Then you have your door handle, which is sleek, and if you open the door, the window goes down, and if you close the door, it goes back up. And then you got your skirts, which is deeper and lower, and the sport is really low to the ground, which gives the car a sporty appearance. And now let's go to the back. So coming to the back, you have got the coupe style back with this huge windscreen over here. You have got your four rings over here, the TT badge, your brake lights. Then you got your brake lights, which is in full red, and you got your blinkers in them. The reverse lights are over here. Down over here, you have got your bumper, which is in black. Then you got your exhaust pipes over here, two of them, which is really sporty and it makes the car look like it's super fast. Over here, you got your fuel tank, and it's got an Audi TT embossed over here. So, now, let's go inside. Let's get in. Oh, this is really spotty to see. So, you got your steering wheel over here. It's a D-shaped steering wheel. And there are no buttons on the steering wheel like in the modern days. You just got your Audi badge only and the horn. Then you have got your dials, you have got your speedometer over here, your rev counter over here, and in the middle you have got a small screen. Over here you have got your paddle shifters. On this side it is plus and this side it's minus. Then you have got your air vents, you have got metallic trim around here, and the air vents is in circle. Then coming over here you have got your Audi console system. And it's probably an infotainment system. Then down over here, you got your climate control, your temperature over here, your fan speed, and the movement of the AC. Then you have your gear selector. It's a circle. Then you have your double indicators over here. And you have got a spoiler in the back, which you could up by using this button over here.
Hold it down.
So here you have got your lights over here, and you have got beige over here on the roof. In the door you have just got your open button, and this is metal. You got your lock and unlock, and you got leather over here. And the door bends are a decent size. You can fit a large bottle, squeezing it like that. Then over here you got your seats. It's in beige, and these are leather, and these are really body hugging seats. See? And now let's go to the back seats. Then you need to put the seats back, which you do like this. See? And you need to put the seat forward. And that's the knees. Then let me get inside over here into the back seat. And let me put this seat back where it was supposed to be. And let me put this down for you guys to see what's happening. See? So this is this space in the area. It's very limited, and the leg room is poor, the headroom is poor, because yeah, there's not space over here. This car is not really good for carrying people in the back, but it's alright for some distances, but not for a long trip. And now let's go to the boot. Oh, let me get out. So the process is done halfway. Now I need to get out. I'm gonna be careful. And I'm out! Yahoo! So here you could open the boot. The boot's open now. So when you open the boot, you have got 290 liters of boot space. It's a huge amount of space, but you cannot carry really lots of things because of the shape of it. And yeah, that's it for the boot. Now let's go to the engine. So you've got a 2-liter 4-cylinder turbo engine with 211 horsepower and 250 newton meters of torque. And now let's close the hood. So guys, that's it for this video. See you soon. Bye.